Hi, I'm Tyler Kerstetter with the West Hanover Township Fire Company. We're located in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Also, we're about 15 minutes from Hershey, and familiar locations for where we are in the Commonwealth. West Hanover Township is a little over 23 square miles. We have three stations, four engines, heavy rescue, and this is replacing in-kind an 1,800-gallon pumper tanker. We have a new Enforcer chassis with a DV13 Detroit 505 horse and a Water 1750 pump. Inside the cab, very similar to all the Enforcer chassis, all the switches are laid out, so everything's easily accessible to the driver or the officer in regards to scene lighting and emergency lighting. Into our crew area, we have a fairly simple crew area. It is six-man cab, mounting plate over the entire engine tunnel, which will be filled with equipment as soon as this gets to click fire equipment, as such of our medical bags, radio charger, tick, air monitor, and map books. Continuing on to the pump house here, this is a 48-inch pump house. We have about everything you can think of on this on a pumper truck. It is laid out as best we can. So cross lays for the driver's side, officer side, front discharges, and then everything's broken out between right and left discharges. We have manual wheels for both the deluge gun and our large diameter discharge on the officer side. The truck does have a 30-gallon fuel cell with a simple Vitalik industrial fittings on both sides, so where we can clip in our foam adductors. And we do have an additional Trident air primer from the front intake to the main sides. Looking down the side of the truck, we do have a flip-down folded tank. There'll be a 2,500-gallon folded tank going in there. Also, on the bottom of that will be a section, a 10-inch hard sleeve, or a 10-foot section of 6-inch hard sleeve. Three-quarter height compartments, 60-inch wide for our pump operator. Continuing back, simple flip down, broom storage, basic tool storage, nothing super fancy. Continuing on, it's another small equipment. We'll have battery fans that go in here. It's a very simple rig when it comes to that. So the back of the truck, especially being essentially a pumper tanker as it has 1,800 gallons on it, is how usable can the back of the, can we make the back of this truck so that we can actually pull the lines. So we have a beaver tail bumper, lots of steps, another nice step here, and we're approximately 70 inches hose bed height on this truck with 1,800 gallons of water on this chassis is very good. Carry 2,000 feet of 5-inch, 300 feet of 3-inch, 500 feet of 2.5, 250 feet of 2.5, and 300 feet of 1¾ inch in the hose bed. Dump chutes are on all three sides, controls both sides of the truck. Ladder storage on low side compartments, hooks, closet ladder, 14 and 24 foot ladder, Zyco racks, two more sections of 10-foot, 6-inch hard sleeve, another dump chute. This side. On this side is our air bottle storage, air cylinder storage, depending on which part of the country you're from. Six bangers. Then moving forward to another 60-inch low side compartment. Let's come to the other side of the pump house on the officer side. Not a whole lot going on. One 2.5-inch discharge, our LDH, our other two cross lays, our controls for our Zyco racks for our hard sleeve, and also we have a 1-inch booster reel coming off this side. In our front bumper, we have a hose tray here for 25 feet of 5-inch, and our steamer connection that does fit a section of sleeve to come in here. And then 200 feet of 1¾-inch hose on the other side for our bumper line. So taking a look at our light package here on the outside, excluding the two Mars lights on the front of the truck, everything is 100% LED. We have a high-vis brow light. We have Whale and Pioneer LEDs on the other three corners of the truck. One thing that's special to us, we sit on top of a small mountain outside of Harrisburg. Very dark, we go back a lot of dirt lanes at times at night, and our lighting package is very important to us. And also, in our first do, we cover numerous miles of Interstate 81, and this rig commonly functions as a blocker by the time it's supporting our rescue operations. And we have additional side scene lighting low and high all the way around the truck to make sure that we're well seen when we're out at night. Thanks for watching.